In this video, I'll show you the process of designing icons dedicated to Valentine's Day. Where do we start when creating an icon set? Is it really that difficult? What's the benefit of making a mood board? Why make a sketch? Which program should you use to create icons? Over my long career, I've heard a lot of questions about icon design. Let's break them down step by step. In my portfolio, I already have around 6,000 icons, and I'm excited to share my design process with you. Valentine's Day is approaching, one of my favorite holidays, and I've decided to create an icon set in its honor. Sure, you can ask AI to create icons for you. However, the results might not be satisfying. In my opinion, designing icons is a meticulous and time-consuming process that AI cannot fully and qualitatively accomplish yet. By the way, let's ask AI to create a few vector icons or the theme of Valentine's Day and see the result at the end of this video. Some designers believe that creating a mood board is unnecessary. They argue that it's a waste of time. But I disagree. I start all my projects by searching for inspiration and generating ideas. To do this, I create a mood board with a rough list of icons, various photos, and illustrations related to the theme. I choose these images based on my emotions and taste, helping me thoroughly explore the topic. Now the mood board is done. Based on it, I'll start sketching. But before that, let me show you my new set of pencils. The set includes 5 metallic pencils of different thicknesses. There are also additional erasers for pencils. And these are colored lids 2 mm thick. It's an excellent set that further inspires me to design icons and logos. But why bother sketching? Can't you design icons directly in Adobe Illustrator? I always sketch for my projects, because it helps visualize all my ideas quickly in the early stages, saving a lot of time in the end. Usually, I create sets of 16 or 20 icons. For this project, I'll make 20 icons. sketch is ready. Now it can be photographed and then transferred to Adobe Illustrator. Based on it, I'll design vector icons. I'm quite tired, so it's time to take a coffee break. You can use any vector editor to create icons, for example Figma or CorelDRAW, but I prefer Adobe Illustrator as I've been working with it for over 10 years. When I create icons in Adobe Illustrator, I use a special file with a module grid for each one icon. This helps me make pixel-perfect icons with editable stroke. After a few hours of work, I've created this icon set dedicated to love and Valentine's Day. You can purchase this icon set and many others on my Gumroad page. This is a universal set and can be used for your projects, whether it's for iOS or Android apps, websites, presentations or graphic design. For a more detailed look at this project, you can check it out on my Behance page through the link in the description box. I appreciate your likes and comments. If you need a set of icons or a logo, you can order them from me. I'm always open to new projects. And you can find the Google form for order in the description box. Also, it's possible that I already have icons in my collection that could suit your project. Well, now let's take a look at the icons that I created in Adobe Illustrator. Some icons look quite good, but they appear overly detailed, more like illustrations. So I asked it to create simpler icons. And here's the result. What do you think of these icons? Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below. I'd love to hear your opinions on the AI-generated icons. Now you can see for yourself how challenging it is to create icon sets. It takes time, but the design process and the final result bring me immense satisfaction.